King Tut.
The legendary Steve Martin.
I know.
Singing about King Tutankhamun and Egypt. You're looking at the Nile River, one of the longest, if not the longest, yeah, river in the world.
Can you imagine somebody actually walking all 4,000 miles of the Nile River?
Our next guest did it. He is a wild adventurer. His name is Levison Wood. He's done all kinds of things. He's fought the Taliban in Afghanistan. And his latest feat, walking the entire length of the Nile River. There he is. He looks a little bit like Crocodile Dundee.
Oh, all right? My goodness.
It's all captured for a special TV show.
Yeah, it's a documentary airing tonight on Animal Planet. Nice to have you here, Levison.
Thank you. My pleasure.
So what made you want to do something like this?
People always ask me why. You know, this for me was an opportunity to push myself to the limits physically and mentally, but also showcase what modern Africa is all about and say, you know, why this iconic river is still important to millions of people.
Now, did you walk right along the edge of the river or did you go inland a little bit?
It depended on the terrain. Most of the time I was right next to the river and it took me through every kind of environment.
I hear the water's really dirty.
Actually, it's not. I was drinking from the river for
You're kidding.
Part. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it was fine.
How long did it take you, by the way?
It took me 9 months through 6 countries and about 7 million steps.
Oh, my goodness. 9 months?
Yeah.
So living outside all that time?
Camping in the desert.
What? Yeah.
It starts where, the Mediterranean?
No, well, I started all the way down in Central Africa in Rwanda and then walked through 6 countries to Egypt.
So meanwhile, there had to be some areas that were a little frightening because it was not only just rural, but maybe war-torn.
That's right, yeah. South Sudan, a civil war started about 2 weeks after I began the journey. So I found myself getting shot at, you know, the whole spectrum, walking through minefields.
Yeah, some of the water doesn't look that clean, by the way. All right, so what was the wildest thing that happened to you along this trip?
I mean, I got chased by hippos. I got snapped up by crocodiles. You know, the whole thing. It was just like one big crazy adventure.
But mentally, how did you keep yourself going, you know, during that time?
That was probably the biggest challenge, was actually motivating myself to wake up in the morning and walk another 25, 30 miles, when sometimes the horizon just didn't change, especially in the desert.
Did you ever stay in hotels or did you rough it, you know, in tents?
For the most part, I'd say like 90% was just roughing it, sleeping outside. When I got to Egypt, you kind of get followed by the police and the military, so you have to stay in hotels.
So what did you learn? What's the big takeaway? What's the big lesson for you here?
The big takeaway for me was that it's not all bad news in Africa. You know, you see on the media bad news, but actually the stories of humanity and the people that looked after me was really reassuring and warming.
I think we have a clip from tonight's documentary. Let's roll it.
Four days ago, Boston and I were arrested by secret police and held for questioning. We've finally been released and given permission to leave. But to follow the Nile, we must go further north, forcing us deeper into the conflict zone.
I don't know if it's going to be too dangerous to continue, but the plan is we're just going to keep going as far as we can get.
So not only were you dealing with war zones, you were dealing with weather conditions.
Yeah.
And I believe that you lost somebody very close to you during this trek.
Yeah, that's right. An American journalist called Matthew Power actually came out to write about the journey and succumbed to heat injury after just 3 days.
Heat injury?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
How did you protect yourself?
I mean, you can only do so much. It's an expedition. There's always going to be risks. And you do what you can. You do your planning. You do your homework.
Well, we're glad you made it home. And we can watch this tonight, Walking the Nile, 8 o'clock on Animal Planet, right?
That's right.
We get that right?
Okay. Nice to meet you. What's your next adventure?
I've got another big one, top secret, but it's not in Africa this time. Different continent.
Interesting. Well, I'd like to walk all of Disney World. Oh, I think I've done that a few times, actually. Anyway, just kidding.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.